Hello everyone, this will be a supplementary video for part 3 of our Metroidvania series where I'll be bringing you through updates like bug fixes and code optimizations, as well as solutions for problems you may encounter. To start things off, if you find that your enemy takes twice the damage than it should, this is caused by the presence of multiple box colliders. There are two methods to solving this, but we will be using the one employed in updating this issue in the article. For this method, we'll be creating an array, a list, to keep track of all the enemies that has been hit in our attack. Then we'll refer to this list when hitting enemies to see if the enemy has already been hit in the same attack to prevent multiple instances of damage going through in one attack. Essentially, a similar code as the one before, with the exception of adding the lines for the list. For the next issue, it'll be that the enemy continues to move while being recoiled. We missed adding a line of code in part 3 when creating our enemy hit function, so simply add isRecoiling equals true to after the force applied for recoiling to allow the enemy to enter their recoiling state and prevent their other actions from occurring. Similarly, for issue 3, the player having infinite attack speed is also caused by an inaccurate code. When creating the float time between attack, we've made it private along with time since attack. However, to create an attack cooldown as intended, we need to control the value of time between attack to be more than 0. Thus, all we have to do is change the time between attack variable to a serialized field variable. From there, experiment and set the value to a reasonable number for your game. That settles the changes we've made to our article and brings us to the one common issue players experience. In the case of the enemy or the player being unable to take damage, we have to check for the following three things. 1. The player is set to tag player with the same capitalization and spelling as the one written in the enemy script. 2. The player has set their attackable layer in the inspector to attackable, or any other similar layer that is used to designate objects to be hit. And 3. The same layer for attackable layer is assigned to the enemy. If all 3 are set appropriately, there should be no issues with your player or the enemy being able to take damage. That brings us to the end of this video. I hope this video has solved your issues and improved your mechanics for part 3 of the Metroidvania series. There will be a link in the description regarding these changes made to part 3 of the series that will cover all of the fixes discussed in this video. If you have a problem or question that has not yet been covered or is a unique circumstance, do head to our community forums at blogterrascore.com in the description for assistance. Thanks for watching and hope you enjoyed the video.